WLS radio host, Man Cow Muller. Got to get that correct there.
Yeah, he'll correct you.
That's why I don't
you.
Do radio. Has many vocal listeners who call in daily to his radio show this week. The news, of course, is about the governor. Apparently something happened there.
Yeah.
And the phone's certainly been lighting up, and Man Cow's with us this morning. So what are people saying? I imagine they're fairly disgusted.
Well, I love how people are shocked that Triple J, Jesse Jackass Jr., as I call him, from the family of race baiters, the family of extortionists, that Jesse Jackson Jr. might be a crook. Well, I mean, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. And then the other thing that I have gotten blasted over is, wow, everybody around Obama's a bad guy. Maybe Obama's a bad guy. Oh, how can you say it? Not the return of Jesus, not the Christ that's going to the White House. He couldn't be a bad guy. Man, I don't know. Have you read the whole indictment? Obama's name is all through this. You got Obama. You got Resco. You got all these crooks.
Now, you were on...
I think this is just the beginning.
You've been saying that before. Yeah. So you're saying the apple doesn't fall from the tree. So you think there's involvement with the president-elect?
Here's the deal. We sent out, WLS sent out reporters to talk to the rear-end Jesse Jackass Sr. He wouldn't talk. Let me tell you something. That is a sign of the apocalypse. When Jesse Jackson Jr. will not talk to an open microphone, we knew something weird was going on. So then when I went on Fox Around the World yesterday, early, and said, it's going to be Jesse Jackson Jr. Oh, we can't. I knew it, and everybody that knows anything in this city knew it was going to be Triple J.
Well, you even were on with Katie Couric last night talking about this. I mean, obviously, a lot of people are shocked. Now, Jesse Jackson Jr. has since come on and has since said, you know what, I don't know nothing about this.
Yeah.
He knew nothing about it.
Oh, no, they never.
He spoke yesterday about this, and you know what? He really might not have known anything
and
about
it. And what do you think of that press conference?
I think it's a joke. I think they're a family of liars. Give him a beer distributorship, and he'll go away for a while.
What are your listeners saying?
Look.
They're shocked about everything still.
I think we're still in a state of shock. I think we had hoped that that Jesse Jr. was a little different from the dad. I've spent hours of personal time with Obama. Obama's speech about race was one of the great speeches of my life. And I hate that old attitude of extortion and race baiting that Jesse Jackson Sr. made his living on. I had hoped that we had moved away from this, and I hope we don't get drugged back to those days. I do think Obama's a breath of fresh air, and I hope that... I mean, look, this is the first scandal of the White House, guys. This is the first scandal of the Obama White House.
Yeah. And Obama has since come out, and he has since asked for the governor to resign.
Remember, this is the tapes we know about are the tapes since the election. How long have they been recording Blago? I do love everybody outside of Chicago. I mean, we got it. We can say Blagojevich. I do love all the national guys. I love the hair. Look at the hair. Elvis Presley, ladies and gentlemen. What the heck is that?
Now listen, here's what's interesting. Okay, so we have
the boy governor.
The sad thing is right now Illinois has become the butt of a lot of jokes. Rich Eisen was just on here with you, Mike.
Crook County, they're calling us.
We're here to talk about sports, and the first thing he brings up, of course, is Blagojevich.
That's what everybody's talking about.
I was talking to New York yesterday. I was doing the business report. The first thing they try to make a joke about is Blagojevich doing a business report in New York. Yeah.
There's nothing funny about this guy. No. He's evil. Everybody around him is evil. I hope Obama's not involved, but I fear he may be.
What's the central theme that your listeners are saying to you?
News is breaking all the time. Mm-hmm. We've broken a couple of big things on WLS, and we're just trying to stay into it. We're just trying to stay on it and cover it as it's breaking, press conferences and all the craziness. I did love Mayor Daley. Early on, I haven't heard anything about this. I didn't have time to watch the news. I have to think the governor of Sodom and Gomorrah is in hell right now saying they destroyed us for less. This city is dirty.
Man Cam Muller, a man who never holds back his opinions and gets paid to do so. Thanks for coming in this morning.
We welcome all the emails you want to send us, and you can send them to him, too. And listen, a lot of people listen to your radio show. Todd Stroger listens to it, clearly.
Todd's called us.
He was on the show. A lot of people listen to you. So
he's completely honest, Todd Stroger.
Feel free to call him as
well. He's not a crook.
All right. See you in Chicago. Cracking down on valet services.
And then we're going to show you some of the wild T-shirts and other gifts as vendors try to cash in on the big scandal involving the governor.
Take any medication.
Yes, I do. Yes. To get up.